According to the Prime Minister, the representatives are committed to making the resources available to the island and taking steps towards preparation and implementation. Prime Minister Stevenson King says the program, Compete Caribbean, will add to economic development, a goal set by his administration to develop the country at large.
As we move to the final stages of institutionalizing the council through its establishment, that we'll begin to see greater collaboration, greater synergies between the public, private sector, and particularly the trade unions. Trade unions need to understand that it's not merely a question of representing the rights of workers and to ensure that workers get the benefits, but it's also about being productive, being efficient, and being competitive. We are on our way, and we're very confident that what I consider to be a new emerging economy here in St. Lucia is underpinned by a council that understands the need for productivity, for competitiveness, and particularly efficiency among our people.
Mr. King says whilst social and physical plans are being developed, there will be implications for social services. The program, he says, will revolutionize the social and economic fabric of the country.
If you recall, a few years ago, we launched what we call the Quadrant Development Plan, which is a national vision plan. It's a spatial plan of what we intend to do in the country, to redevelop cast trees, to renew cast trees. The question of how do we develop places that are not yet developed to a standard, and how we consolidate on the achievements that we've made, the physical, infrastructural, developmental achievements that we've made. We believe that with this council being established, it will certainly help us crystallizing those intentions and taking it forward beyond a spatial plan, beyond a physical plan.
The approximately $40 million for the Compete Caribbean program will come from the Inter-American Development Bank. For the DBS News World, Jason Holland-Seed reporting.